It's Jackie, registered dietitian, and today we're finding out what's in my fridge. So let's get to it. So it's important to have a well-stocked fridge, which will make it easy to create healthy meals throughout the week for you and your family. I want to walk you through some of the things that I like to prep and have ready to go for quick and easy meals. So I'm going to start with what I have on my prep shelf. First off, I love egg whites, so I always have egg whites in my refrigerator. That's what I eat basically every morning, is an egg white omelet. And my kids get milk, so I have some organic milk, and you'll see in the back some almond milk. That's what I like in my coffee, not for any particular reason other than I just like the way it tastes. You'll see all of my glassware, which is where I keep my prepped food. So I'll start nice and easy. I prepped some lentils over the weekend, and I've just got like a variety of mushrooms and vegetables in here, so I'll pair that with rice, or I'll put it over maybe a little bit of pasta, and it's a quick meal that I enjoy during the week. I also have a bunch of vegetables always prepped. I think that's huge, is to make sure that you have plenty of vegetables, because I find that when you're tight on time, that's the one food group that people tend to bail on. So if you've got all of your veggies already prepped in the beginning of the week, you're more likely to consume them, of course. Some of my favorites, I do a mix of like zucchini with bell peppers and onions. I love green beans, mushrooms. So there's really, no right or wrong. It just depends on what you like, but also be mindful of what's gonna keep up in the fridge for a couple of days. So those are some of the vegetables that I think last, at least 3 to 4 days without getting like overly soggy. Next, I have what I've got for lunch for today and tomorrow. Tofu. I love tofu. I eat it several times a week as part of typically my lunches because it's easy to prepare in the morning, so I have that ready to go. Then last week I shared one of my videos. I was talking about the glass containers. If you missed that, one of the things I wanted to mention was one of my tips on helping to prevent food waste. One of the things that I've always done is I write the date or the day of the week that I think the food item should either be frozen or thrown out or consumed. Hopefully not thrown out. So here I have Friday. So by Friday, I should either consume this or put it in the freezer for another day so that you don't have to end up throwing things out once you realize, oh my gosh, I have no idea how long that turkey's been in there. You know what? It's time to get rid of it. So definitely write the date of when that food item should be consumed by or frozen. Down below, I've got some, so that was ground turkey. So that'll translate into different meals throughout the week, tacos, over pasta, rice, that kind of thing. Then I've got some turkey breast that I roasted last night. So again, that's something that can translate either into sandwiches or wraps or other meals throughout the week. Up here, this is typically where I keep my kids' food. So I've always designated a shelf for them. That way, it's easy for anyone who's watching them, my parents or a babysitter, to identify what foods they can have that are safe for them and also appropriate. So for dinner tonight, I made a baked ziti for them over the weekend. So that's what they're having. I've got some pasta that's here ready to go. If that way one child has a meltdown on not liking their dinner, pasta is almost like a sure thing for them. I've got also some lentils here, a variety of fruits. They love berries. I always have that for them. Prepped sauce. So I made a tomato sauce over the weekend. So I have that in a jar ready to go over a pasta as well. Up top, a variety of breads. We have everything from English muffins, pita breads. I love Ezekiel bread, so that's what I have up there. And then I'm not sure if you can see it, but a huge, huge container of pickles, which are my husband's. I don't do pickles. Then as we go below, we love yogurt as a snack. So I have a couple of different yogurts, extra container of tofu, eggs, and so on. So as you get down below in my refrigerator, that's where I have some fruits and other vegetables, but I've prepped most of my stuff, so the bottom part of my refrigerator is kind of empty. Some other things that I think prevent food waste as well is washing your herbs when you get home so that they're ready to use when you're ready to use them. I know that sounded weird. So parsley. Parsley is something that I love using, but I hate washing it, right? You're ready to use it, you wanna just chop up some parsley, and it's not washed, so you're less likely to use it. So washing it ahead of time will help prevent that situation. So condiments, I love, we're like a regular family. I love ketchup. It's probably the most obnoxious thing I eat, but we love nut butter, so I always have natural almond butter, natural peanut butter for my kids, you know, Parmesan cheese and your regular things that most people have in their refrigerators. Let's move on to the freezer. Here we are in my freezer. So one of the things that I like to do is if I'm prepping a large amount of any particular food item is I'll freeze it in a single layer before storing it. So here I have my sweet potatoes. Me and my youngest Nico are big sweet potato fans. So I'll roast them and then I'll put them on a cookie sheet in a flat layer. And when I'm ready to put them in, let's say a freezer bag, you know, you just put them in there and they're already frozen so they won't stick together. So that's one tip there. Some other things that I think really freeze well for later on in the week for different meals, rice, roasted potatoes, always really freeze well. I have a variety of frozen vegetables that also translate into quick and healthy meals throughout the week. I always have a bag of shrimp. I think that that's a tasty way to get, you know, some fish into your diet as well. My kids love pancakes. I have those here, waffles. So a variety of different things in my freezer that probably most people have. Just be mindful to not forget that they're there. Most food items are gonna last in your freezer about 3 months, and that just becomes a quality issue over time. It'll just lose its flavor or its quality. So 3 months is a good guideline for most foods in the freezer, okay? So I hope that you enjoyed walking through my fridge and my freezer. If you have any questions about food prep, how long things should stay in the refrigerator, what can go in the freezer, just send me a message and I'll be glad to answer your questions. Thanks for watching.